Hi, I'm Kwan. In this video, I'm going to show you how to conduct group activities or discussion using Google Meet. There are several options to do group activities or discussion. One of them is using Breakout Rooms. However, there is no built-in Breakout Rooms feature in Google Meet yet, but I'm going to show you how we could do that manually. To do so, just follow these three simple steps. First, create. Second, share, and third, install. I'm going to share with you each of these steps in detail shortly. Let's focus on the first step, create. First, you will need to create a place for your students to work in groups. The concept is simple. If you need four groups, then you'll need four different rooms. If you have three groups, then you will need three different rooms, so on and so forth. So in this case, the room is referring to the Google Meet that you have created. To do a quick one-off discussion, you may just go to go.meet and create four different Google Meet rooms. Google Meet is available for free to everyone for now, but if you have a G Suite account, please make sure that you switch to it. So to create the meeting, click on Join or Start a Meeting. You can either enter the meeting code or nickname or just leave it blank. So, but one note, if you wish to enter the meeting code, please make sure that it's more complicated. Something like this, maybe your subject code or something like that, to avoid outsiders from joining the meeting easily. For me, normally I'll just leave it blank. Then just press continue. It shall direct you to this particular page, and you have just done creating the first room. What you need to do is that you can just go to here, just copy and paste this particular link, and this link is the key to the first room. For demo purpose, let's assume that we have a total of three groups. So in that case, we will need three additional rooms for the students. So we have done one. To create another two rooms, what you need to do is just repeat the same steps like what we did for the first room. So you go to the website, click join or start a meeting. So you can just leave it blank or you can enter group 2. Then again, you will find the meeting room, and this is the link to the second room. So we have created the second room. To do for the third room, so to create the third room for group number 3 perhaps, so we repeat the same process again. So now you will have another link generated, or in other words, a new room. So we have all three rooms together. And that's how you can create breakout rooms for group discussion or activities using Google Meet. It's very simple, isn't it? But please take note that the steps on creating the rooms just now were only meant for one-off or a quick discussion, or in other words, you will not use the rooms again in the future. For recurring classes or meetings such as every week, every day, that would not be advisable since the link may expire after some time. In that case, for recurring classes or meeting, I will strongly recommend you to create the Google Meet link or the rooms using Google Calendar instead. If you wish to find out more about how to create and schedule recurring meetings using Google Calendar, you may check out my video in the video description box below. Once you have created the breakout rooms, in our case, three rooms for three groups, the second step would be to share the link with your students. In order to allow your students to enter their room based on their groups, respectively, you will need to give them the key to the group's room. In this case, the key is referring to the unique Google Meet link that we have created just now. There are many options to share. You may simply email your students, or even better, if you can publish the link in Google Classroom. But before you do so, you may want to compile them in one place so that it's easier for you to keep track or navigate. For easy sharing, you may want to use Google Doc or Google Sheet or Google Slides, up to you. To compile and share the created breakout rooms just now, just go back to the Google Meet page. Copy the link, like For instance, this is the first room that we had. So you just copy and paste it either in a Google Doc or Google Sheet or Google Slides, up to you. So I'll just show you example. If you want to put it in Google Doc, no problem. Or you want to put it in Google Slides, perhaps, or Google Sheet, sorry. You can do that as well. Or you can just put that into a Google Slides, up to you. Okay, so like for instance, if let's say you want to put it here, I would suggest maybe you can put it in the table, so that it's easy to navigate. Alright, so we will have the group and also what is their breakout rooms. Okay, so like for group 1, 2 and 3. So what we had just now is that we have copied down the link from the first, then I'll just have to paste it, like what you can see over here. Okay, paste it and go to the second room. Then we just go and copy down the link again and go back to the Google Doc just now. Then we just paste it. And the third one, okay, so this is the third room. So we just have to copy and paste and place it over here, the breakout rooms. So as you can see, we have three different unique codes. So those who are from group number 1, they will have to go here. Group number 2, go here, and so on and so forth. So of course you have the choice. You can publish that using the Google Doc, or you want to put it in a presentation, also no problem. Maybe a form like this, okay? So you will have the breakout rooms detail. So then you can just tell them, your students announced it. So those are the breakout rooms for group activities. Then you can share this file to them. Or something that I have prepared in advance, this is for my class. I actually do that using my spreadsheet. You can do something like this as well. Again, up to your preference. So like for instance, maybe you want to make it more interesting, like I have four groups, then they will have their own meeting rooms like this. So group 1, the elves, so they have this and this. So again, you can share the list with your students, then they know their name and how they where to go during the online group discussion or meetings. But again, for recurring classes or meetings, or in other words, you wish to reuse the rooms multiple times, not just one time, like in my case, please make sure to create the breakout rooms using Google Calendar instead. The tutorial video is available in the link in the video description box below. And just a quick note, do make sure that you also have a main room where you can gather all of your students in one place before or after the group discussion or activities. You may follow exactly the same step to create the main room, or I would strongly recommend creating it using the Google Calendar. And next, how to share this information to your students. So regardless whether you are using Google Doc or you're using Google Sheet or Google Slides, there will be a button on top right hand corner where you can share the file. So you just have to do some settings. So just go here and click on share. As default, the file is not viewable unless you do some settings. So first, you can probably look at the settings first. So you can pick either you allow them to, if you appoint any editors, or you allow download, print and copy. So if let's say it's okay with that, then you can just leave it like that. Secondly, more importantly, is to get the link. So you have to just change and see whether, as long as people have this link, they will be able to view it. Okay, so if you are done, then you just copy it and pretty much done. Once you got the link, you can either just, as simple as just email the students by just pasting the information about the file here, so that our students, they can refer to the link and to go to their breakout rooms. Or even better, I would suggest to go to your Google Classroom, then just click on Create Material. So you can just add the link over here. Or you can just share by looking into Google Drive and attach the file also. There's no problem doing that. Or if you have the link, then you can just copy and paste and it will show here. Then, of course, I would suggest you to put in a create a topic, maybe breakout rooms, so that it's easier for students to navigate later. So once you have filled up all the details and post, you shall be able to see it appear on the classwork. So you can of course move around if you don't want it to be on top, or you can, from student perspective, they can just click on it and they can just click on this link and it shall direct them to this particular page. How does it look like in real class? So this is actually taken from one of my classes. As you can see, there are four groups actually doing their discussion in their room respectively with their team members. So we have four groups all together, like group number one over here. Then we have group number two also doing their discussion in their room. And also we have group number three at the bottom. And last but not least, we have group number four. So all four groups, they are actually doing their discussion all at the same time, and once they have done, they will come back to this main room. And we are pretty much done. We have successfully created and shared the Google Meet breakout rooms to our students. As for the third step, install, it is actually optional, but I would strongly recommend you to consider installing a few Google Chrome add-ons to better coordinate the online group discussions or activities. So if you are keen, you may check out the next video by clicking the link in the video description box below or here. Thank you for watching and happy teaching!